welcome, please, Scotland's own Stephen Hendry.
He only came of age in January. He's already won over £1 million. He's becoming the hottest property in snooker. How soon before he takes over from the best ever, Steve Dace? Well, that, of course, is Stephen Hendry, the 21-year-old from Edinburgh, and tonight coming into the arena there to start his second-round match. Hendry is the most successful player of the season already here in the Embassy World Championship at the Crucible. He's beaten Alain Robidoux, a very good French-Canadian. Hey, we thought he might have a bit of trouble with that. It was a good match, but he's through, and now he plays Tony Meehan. We're going to that match in this program, and there's the state of the game. Jimmy White and John Virgo at 4-all. Virgo's done well this afternoon. They have two more sessions tomorrow. Mike Hallett struggled all day against the brilliant young Welshman Darren Morgan. There's their score, and they finish tomorrow. Terry Griffiths is starting out tonight against Tony Knowles with an overnight score of 5-3. We'll have some of that in our evening programs. But we begin with the start of Stephen Hendry versus Tony Meehan.
And that's not the best shot in the world from Stephen. Meant to hold the white for this red into the right-hand corner.
Difficult for Tony Meehan.
Stephen Hendry, one. while Stephen Hendry four and a miss.
Now, referee John Williams has given the miss there, and Stephen said, well, let's have a look at that again. So he replaces the cue ball. And Tony's got to get a bit nearer to that bunch of reds. It's a fairly big target to go at.
Yes, no surprise Tony was so short on the first one because he couldn't do any damage as long as he reached them.
I think Stephen can get at the red on the side cushion just above the centre pocket there, but the problem is getting the cue ball back into bulk, and I don't think he can hit the outside of the red to be able to do that.
And Stephen, a little fortunate there. Played to screw back to the bolt cushion and hoping the red would hit something at this end of the table and stay down here.
One choice that you've just seen there. That's very nicely placed. The pink loose in the middle of the table.
Twelve. 90. Stephen Hendry, 90.
So the first real scoring chance for Tony Mayo. Not too difficult to pot the red here, but we'll need a little bit of luck, I think, trying to disturb the black.
One.
Managed to disturb the black, but I don't think we'll see him take this one on.
Tony
Mio, 1. Using plenty of chalk there.
Two
That could be useful in a moment, bringing the black out there. Both have been treating one another with respect, waiting for a mistake. Could this be the mistake of Tony Meehan? This, of course, the first of 25 frames in this match, played over three sessions. And both these young men, in fact, made the semi-finals of the World Championship last year. Stephen Hendry here was defeated by Steve Davis, and Tony Meehan lost out to John Parrott. Points ahead now, and only 59 points left. Stephen has just spotted it appears to be on the table rather than on the ball. The 21-year-old young Scotsman.
37.
Setting his sights, in fact, on being the youngest ever world champion. That's his aim this year, 1990. Goes to 50. These last five colors should be a formality.
Yes, Talon, certainly looking pretty sharp tonight.
Four.
and black to go for a break of 77. So he fails at 64, but he's still got the first frame of our 25 after this photo.
All the attention on Hendry, but you shouldn't forget who he's playing. Tony Meo is here for the 10th year. He reached the semi-final last year, his best ever performance, and he was also the 1989 British Open champion, and in that championship, he beat Stephen Hendry. So Stephen Hendry, we're well aware of that as he breaks off for frame two.
Virtually the same shot that Tony left Stephen off the break off in the first frame.
That one. I must say that was a bit unfortunate. I was right behind the shot there and I couldn't envisage the cue ball going into the centre.
And what's worse, of course, it's given Tony perhaps the simple shot he needs to get his confidence going. The big question, of course, will the black go? Looks it from here.
Seven.
And obviously Tony thinks so too.
Thank you.
22. He could possibly hold for the black here, but may elect to go down for the blue. Won't be too happy with that one.
No, quite right, John. He's landed short. A cue ball running away from the reds.
And a nice little touch on the black for Tony there, but I think if he wants to continue this break, he's going to have to try and get into the edge of those reds. May like to try and, of course, stun the white, round the angles, round the yellow, down for this red into the same pocket as he's playing the black.
Now he has got a chance this time of going into the pack. Stephen just looking around there, in fact. It is amazing, John, the in-off that Stephen just had, the amount of confidence it gives to Tony. Here he is now, break of 44.
That's right, Teddy. He looked very tentative in that first frame. And, of course, the in-off gave him that easy start to the break. And in actual fact, he's been very unfortunate the way the reds have split there. This certainly isn't easy.
maybe just room for that pink to go on its own spot.
50.
That removes the awkward one.
42.
One point ahead, and a joy to watch.
49. 50.
A bundle of talent between these two young men. But the young men from Scotland is really quite outstanding.
52. 54. 61.
In the first frame, his winning break was 64. Tony Mio kicked off the second frame with a 48, and this is the reply by the wee Ben from Scotland. A clearance of 79 to go two frames in front.
Good start for Hendry. The third is actually going on at the moment. Let me tell you where it started. Mio had got a red down. He missed a black, let Hendry in, and Hendry pumped in a break of 64. Then he broke down, and he let Mio back in. That frame is now being played. We'll see it here live in the Crucible on this Saturday night, and there it is. You've missed nothing at all. 65 to Hendry, one to Tony Mio, a break of 64 by Hendry, and it's Mio back at the table. Third frame, Mio yet to get one on the board in this second round match, best of 13. Ted Lowe.
Yes, thank you, David. And Tony Mio with a bit of a task here. 5 reds left, 64 behind. There's only 67 points with those 5 reds, the black with each and the 6 colours. Young Stephen Hendry in devastating form so far. Oh, that's a nice one. You'll notice that Tony has a habit of pulling his shirt sleeves up. I suggest in this particular match he'd better try pulling his socks up.
That looks as though he's overhit that one. And a chance gone missing there. Should certainly have been onto one of these reds into this left-hand corner pocket.
Six points separating them. 59 points on the table. And Tony Meo immediately applauding that shot by Stephen. Cue ball tucked right behind the pink. Great sportsmanship between these two young stars. In fact, within all the top stars of snooker, the same sportsmanship applies.
Tony going for the loose red on the right here. Well, has to hit this. Wouldn't have required snooker that he missed it. If Stephen pops this red, he still requires snookers.
This is Stephen's 5th entry into the World Championship. He got to the quarterfinals in 1987. Last year he made the semi-finals. This year he's hoping to become the youngest ever world champion. Well, Stephen has taken that one, and therefore the first 3 on the trot.
Great start by Stephen Hendry, 3-0. I can tell you the score on the other match. Terry Griffiths has had another frame to the overnight. He's now 6-3 up. That's it. We're back at 10:05. Both matches.
7.
Well, I don't think he can see sufficient of that red to pot it. It's a very close thing. It could.
15.
Yes, it would have been a disaster for Tony had he not been able to pot that red. He'd had many chances this evening, and this is one he'll certainly be looking to try and clinch the frame at this visit.
27.
Of course, that shot Tony's just played. If he can pot this red, he has opened up the path of the other red into the corner pocket.
Certainly made it very awkward for himself here. So decides against any pot at all. He's 34 points ahead now, but there's still 5 reds left.
That's what Tony wants to do, of course, is get a couple of these reds near the cushion. Makes it more difficult for Stephen to clear up. think Steve's been rather fortunate again. You see, though the black is just covering the red over the corner. Although I'm sure we'll see Tony try and pot it with side. Try and swerve it round.
In fact, the curve was too severe. Swerved it too much. He's dodging around all over the place here.
Consolation for Tony, of course, is he has got the reds in rather difficult positions.
Tony can hit one of the four reds this time. Now the four reds are in somewhat pottable positions.
Yes, this is the key one. We just pot this, he should finish on one of the bolt colours. Time a better chance for Tony. A shot to nothing, so less pressure on it for him.
That puts him 35 points ahead.
Eight.
Still 51 points left.
Still requires a colour on one of these two reds. Could have done with being a little harder there, but
12.
I'm sure Tony can pinch this frame. He'll be happy the way Stephen's played. To be only 3-1 down.
Points the difference then. 43 points on the table. The two reds, two blacks, and the six colours.
Of course, that's one of the problems for Stephen here. Would like to go down for one of the lesser colours.
So a chance for Tony Mio here to put a frame on the scoreboard. Trailing at the moment, 3-0. For the cue ball to go round the table and onto that last red.
Eight.
Well, that's unfortunate.
including the old, 8.
Stephen then wanting 3 snookers.
And he didn't get them, so Mio had opened the account as they went to the interval. They've only met on one occasion in recognised tournament play. That was in last year's British Open, when Mio won 5-3 and went on to win the title. And, of course, last year, you shouldn't forget that Tony Mio reached the semi-final of this World Championship. Well, Mio had a good chance to take the next and lost it, so it's Hendry at 4-1.
Touching ball. Tony Mio, 5.
No other choice of trying to shift both reds away from the black spot. So black spot covered.
Eight.
When black goes on the yellow. And although he's got an easy red on, now a bit more difficult for the position.
And it appears he's found one up here this time. Have to go back down for the blue. Black.
Well, if he could get the black back on its spot and good position on a red, would certainly help him a lot.
Is Stephen looking a little bit fed up with life there?
Well, he's had a good study and doesn't look too disappointed, so I feel he can get through to this.
36.
And 41 points in front now.
Yes, and that's another well-controlled shot by Tony, played with bottom and left-hand side. This is certainly a great chance for Tony to clinch this frame.
this Tony's highest break so far in the match. And break goes to 60.
60.
Six reds left now.
Yes, and this black to put the frame out of Stephen's reach. I have to say this has been a good break by Tony. So blacks with the last three reds would be 135. Two reds are a little difficult.
92.
Screwing back for another black. 92. So Tony Meo fails at 92, but he's done enough to win the frame and now trails by two frames at 2-4.
Seventh frame, Tony Meo to break.
Eight. Nine. Still a couple more loose reds available in this left-hand corner. That now has opened the path for the one at the back of the pack there into the left hand corner pocket.
32.
But this is the last one down this end of the table. We'll either have to go into the pack after the black or play for the loose one at the bulk end of the table.
33. Break goes to 40. Stephen Hendry been forced to sit in his chair for some while now.
And now looks to have the perfect angle to drop behind the red into the centre, but these are always a little frightening, having to play them slow across the nap. Yes, and it's that much too thick.
46.
Nice 46, and he's left nothing on the table for Stephen Hendry.
has that touch on the blue, giving Tony a chance to get through to this red. It has, so an excellent chance for Tony here. And suddenly, Tony's looking a different player now.
Yes, amazing, John, isn't it? Snooker is a fascinating game, isn't it? For the first three frames, Stephen Hendry just dominated the play. And now, all of a sudden, it's Tony Meo keeping Hendry sat in his chair.
Yes, and that last frame was a big one for Tony. He attacked the game, I think, for the first time, and it came off for him, and of course giving him that bit of confidence. And 61 in front, so just the blank and one more red. And that's not too good a shot from Tony. Overhit that one. A good red. The frame well beyond the reach of Stephen now.
28.
Ahead, a colour to come, and only 59 points left on the table. Tony Meo, 38.
So Tony Meo gets another one back. We will be giving you coverage tonight of Terry Griffiths and Tony Knowles, as I told you earlier. Griffiths went into a lead of 6-3, but now the last frame of the session between Tony Meo and Stephen Hendry.
Well, I don't think that was how Stephen expected to finish on the black. But he has done, although it's not easy, this one.
And now to split the pack. 30. Is he fortunate?
Well, he certainly has a red on into this right-hand corner, but not as easy as he would have liked. A bit near the cushion.
Number of loose reds there, as you saw.
47.
But he's just got the cue ball in a situation where he can't putt anything.
47.
Yes, that was a little unfortunate for Stephen there, just kissing into the reds awkwardly, everyone covering the other, so nothing else to do but play safe.
Thank you.
1.
Trickling up behind the brown this time.
John Neal, 1.
For the red on the top cushion. It's a good one. That's a good shot.
Nice one. Surprised me there, Ted. Thought he was going to play safe off that.
Tony Mio, 4.
And that miss there was caused by bad positional shot.
One.
Running the cue ball into those three reds when putting the black this time. Ahead. That's it.
17.
Tony wanting snookers. But somehow I don't think he'll get back to the table.
Stephen Hendry, 40.
And Tony Mio concedes. So our first session of eight frames between these two young stars finishes with Stephen Hendry leading 5-3.
So that's their day over, and that's how they'll start again tomorrow. Davis will play Neil Folds in the quarterfinal. Terry Griffiths was 11-5 against Knowles overnight. This morning, Griffiths has gone through. Griffiths, a winner by the score of 13-6, and he will now play either Jimmy White or John Virgil. Stephen Hendry against Tony Meehl, Mike Hallett against Darren Morgan, all being played to a finish today, and a pairing decided there, Cliff Thorburn versus John Parrott. We'll start this morning with Stephen Hendry and Tony Meehl. 5-3, as you saw, overnight. It's been a very good match indeed. Tony Meehl playing some of his best snooker for a long time. Here's the first frame they play today. No score yet. Meehl eyeing up a plant.
Chance here for Tony to score a few. The black is tied up, but both pink and blue available.
Eighteen. Thirty-two. Thank you.
38.
Just about got the angle on this red to run round the angles. What would certainly have liked a little more angle on the shot.
Yes, he did very well there. With considering the bridging, that was quite a tricky set of balls to get across. And this time it's a different kettle of fish. This is a nasty one.
Yes, would be going back to the bulk end of the table playing that, but I think quite rightly making sure of a safety shot.
Tony Mayo, 45.
That's a very good start from Tony.
Stephen's looking there as though he played that shot. Well, had he have got it and played for it, it would have been a magnificent shot, but under the circumstances, I think it was a rather reckless attempt. That was a very difficult shot indeed.
And again,
fine.
Judged to perfection by Tony. The red just above the black there into this right-hand corner. Could disturb the black here, but I think we'll probably see him screw back for the pink.
Well, Tony's certainly making the pink work overtime.
Yes, and just need a little more side on the white there. Tending to just lose position that little bit here. Can still pot the pink, but The next red's going to be the difficult one. And of course, with a 58-point lead, he still needs one more red to make this frame safe. So now 64 points in front, 67 on the table, so I'm pretty sure we won't see Tony move that black from where it is. But Stephen, to win this frame, is going to have to get at least two or three blacks.
Certainly an excellent red, and don't know what Tony had for breakfast this morning, but it's working
Tony
well.
20.
Must have been at least three shredded wheat, because he knocked in another break of 34 after that. He'd taken the frame. Hendry hadn't potted a ball. 5-4. Into the next. Hendry's behind again, but the set of the balls do look rather inviting.
Well, the black going on the pink spot, of course, has blocked the two up, but Stephen has an angle here to disturb those if he wishes.
Yes, I think the excellent first frame in the potting of Tony Meo has put Stephen on his mettle, and he's just now building 60. Back that little bit of confidence that's necessary. Little indecision here, just which is the best angle, yellow or green. Red's sitting nicely.
And I think he's got all of that too well, Jack. Don't know whether this red will go into the left-hand corner, but looking at Stephen's face, it doesn't appear it will.
No, it looks as though he might have to roll this one down the cushion, John. But he can hold this with a pink. Sort of shot when you're buzzing and playing well you don't think too much about, but there we are, that went in easy enough.
Fifty-five. 56.
So, Stephen cleared all the reds and Tony in trouble. And what a good performance. Sat out for the first frame, whitewashed.
70. Seventy-eight.
90. So, if possible, 103. And what a good break. What a test of character, temperament, call it what you will, sat out for the first frame. Both players playing well. So great stuff by Stephen Hendry. He gets his frame back. He leads 6-4.
Yes, of course, there have been seven bigger century breaks than that. Still top of the list for the £12,000 prize is Steve James on 135. On to the next frame then. Hendry is behind, but he's been let in again.
Yes, beautifully judged on the red.
And this time trying to make sure he had an angle on the blue to split the pike, but may have just overhit it a little. Can still go into the pike off this blue, but this is a bit thinner than it would have liked. And of course needs the usual bit of luck with the split of the pike. And although he's got it red into the right and centre, the shot he played deserved a better fade. And again, rather unfortunate for Stephen. After the pot in the middle, he was back in prime position, but now hampered by this red, and this isn't easy. And should he miss this, of course, he'd be putting Tony in.
2.
So Stephen back in full flow. One has to say he's pulled some magnificent pots out in to keep this break going. And now 44 points in front.
56.
So just a red and black would be sufficient to leave Tony the snookers.
57.
Oh, and that's come very nicely.
64.
Just about right.
65.
So the frame nice and safe, and every chance now for Stephen to try and
71.
Get another century, why not? Oh dear.
Stephen Hendry.
Now why did I say that?
You know, we've often wondered that, Jack. But it was framed to Hendry, 7-4. That brings us to the end of our Sunday lunchtime update. Here's the situation. Griffiths, a winner today. There's the Hendry score. That'll be in Grandstand this afternoon. And there the menu for the rest of the day. And what a finish in store for tonight. Jimmy White, Virgo, Hendry, Mio. We have two programmes tonight. This is the first shot. Seven. Tony Mio, 7.
Well, Tony trying to do a little too much with the pot on the blue. Perhaps a little lucky not to have left Stephen a simple starter.
the centre bump has given Stephen his first opportunity here, I think. Yet to score in this frame.
Yes, he shouldn't have any problem knocking the red into the corner, but the angle is going to take the cue ball back along the cushion if he does the straightforward screw shot. And there, trying to pinch a little bit.
Stephen Hendry, 7.
So it's a fairly slow start from the young Scot. Tony's taken the extension off the cue, so I think it's highly unlikely that he's going to have a go at the black.
6.
And yet, in fact, Ray, it's on, isn't it? One would have thought he might have had a go at that. He could do no harm by... I know it's awkward to get at, but the cue ball would go safe, I would have thought, even if he missed it.
Yeah, he's not a very big fella, you know, Ted, and playing over the top of that red there... His vision would have been a little bit restricted from the far end, and I think he was probably right to do that.
Stephen waiting for a better opportunity to cash in.
Yes, Ted, I think that's a sign of his maturity now, you know. less than 18 months ago, he would certainly have had a go at the green, deep screw and all kinds of side on it, but he's learnt very rapidly that discretion can often be the right thing to use. Opportunity that Stephen was waiting for.
Eight.
Bruce, you had a shave this morning? When he came to the table, he was 29 points behind. That black puts him 2 points ahead.
31. 32.
The last red.
38.
He's looking for two frames.
39.
The pink would have been worth 6 points, but the brown is going to give him near perfect position on the yellow to finish off the frame.
14 points ahead, but he's left the last 6 points.
5.
And that looks about perfect for Tony Meo to take the cue ball across the table, the other side of the table, down for the blue.
14.
All square at the moment. He wants the pink and black. A black ball frame. Change of fortunes in our first frame. It seemed that Stephen Hendry had it sewn up, missed the yellow, and Tony takes the frame, now trailing 6-11. Can't quite see from here, but it appears he's putting this red into the middle. Now, have they been kind to him?
That's about the worst possible position. I think he may well take the yellow on for the corner pocket here.
That was a terrific shot, Ray.
Yes, some players, Ted, you know, after they've just lost a frame that they should have won, hang the head with Stephen. It seems to spur him on. Spoke too soon.
Stephen Hendry, 11.
Tony looking extremely smart this evening with bow tie and waistcoat to match.
8. Thank you.
24.
Well, Tony's finished just the wrong side of the blue. But he's had a look at the red alongside the yellow. Obviously, he feels that he can hit enough from that angle to knock it in. Break goes to 51.
51.
Yes, he really should win it from here, Ted. Every chance.
It seems that there was a bad contact when he played that red. But he still wants a colour and one more red to make the frame safe.
Yes, having to take the cue ball that extra 18 inches away from the reds made it that much more difficult. So Stephen, with enough balls on the table to win, perfect angle to bring a red out from this black.
That's a bit unfortunate to put the red so close to the blue. Terrific pop from Mio. He's looking at the scoreboard. He's 47 points of, in front now with only 43 left on the table.
Johnny Mio, one.
So Stephen Hendry wanting one snooker.
Well, he didn't get it. In fact, Hendry produced a foul shot to end the frame. So Mio has won the two in a row here tonight. We're carrying on with the match, but just to remind you, tonight later on here, we'll have our first look at Shot of the Championship, where you have the chance to win two tickets to all sessions of the final next Saturday and Sunday. All expenses paid, money no object. On with the match, frame 19.
Well, that's the second time he's done that this evening. With practice, he'll make it perfect. And things not going too well for young Stephen Hendry so far this evening.
One. One.
No, it's not worked out. As you see, Stephen's left Tony a red to this corner, but it looks to be pretty nigh on straight. He's not going to be able to do too much with the cue ball. And I think he's just settled for the 1 point and now try and put the cue ball down behind the yellow. Little surprised at Tony there. Plenty of reds this side of the table for Stephen to play safety off. If he'd have tried to go the other side, it wouldn't have been quite so easy. Good safety attacking shot there from Stephen Hendry. He's broken the balls, as you see, hoping that Tony here will make a mistake and he can get in. Plenty of room to get his hand on the table. It'll certainly be the black, but may take it to the corner, may take it to the centre. I think it could be the corner. Two good shots. I'll put him in prime position.
Nine. Thirty-two.
48.
So the break passes that half century.
62.
Virtually sure to be enough. To get rid of the more difficult of the two reds. There's a possible 120 if he can take blacks with these two reds and then clear the colours. Stephen made three century breaks in the afternoon session this match.
78.
Good shot required now to get to the brown, but nothing seems to be beyond this young man when he's start to go.
98.
Well, a fabulous green, but he's too short of the century and in trouble to putt this brown. 12 frames to 7 and wants one more for victory. The 21-year-old Scotch wizard then breaks off, looking for one frame now to go into the quarterfinals. Against the wall, he wants six frames. very tall alder indeed. Good shot.
Twenty-four. 25.
There's still one red at the back of the pack there to go into the same corner as the black. I think Tony's just about got enough angle to get the cue ball back behind it.
32.
32. Now to open the reds up. Just depends how they break apart.
40.
Not too kind. 40. Red to the left there, certainly too narrow an angle to take on. 40. Well, the red Stephen's taken on means that the cue ball's going to open all the reds.
One.
Just nudged a couple out, but there's enough there to give Stephen a good chance.
24, 25.
And Stephen's noticeably taken just a little more time. I think he knows, Ted, that this could be a match winner.
Yes, I think you're right, Ray. He's got one loose red to have a go at here, and then I think he's got to disturb something.
32.
33. There's his eye on the outside one there. Referee John Williams, who is the senior referee, is putting the pink right in the middle of the reds there.
Never seen that before, Ted.
Nor have I, no.
John using the marker to remove a red to get the pink in the proper position.
And he's done it perfectly.
Without a quiver.
Congratulations, then, to referee John Williams as he respots the pink, and that is quite amazing.
40.
Now to disturb these last four. There's a plant there.
47.
But he's taking the right-hand one, the outside red.
48.
Now 8 points ahead. This the frame. Tony wondering, in fact, if he can get back to the table.
52.
Well, that would appear to be the end of the break. He's 12 points ahead. 51 points left. Tony now fighting to save the match. Looking at this plant, now is that on? Is it in a direct line with this pocket?
Yes.
let himself awkward over the blue and a distance down the table.
Well, as you can see, Tony can get through to the red near the pink, but if he takes this on and misses it, he's almost certain to leave the other red. So it could be that he's just playing the safety shot. We will see.
Now, I think Stephen can get to the red nearest the pocket. There's a gift for Tony Meo. He's 5 points behind. Giving himself a chance. It's all square.
Well, he appears to have just the right angle on the pink to take the cue ball down for the yellow, and then if he gets this one right, it should be plain sailing.
A bad miss. But he didn't get his position either. He's not left it for Stephen. He's a lucky fella. Oh, well, I take that back. I didn't think he could see enough of it.
No, I think you were fooled a bit by Stephen playing that with a lot of right-hand side to pinch a bit there, Ted. That's why he hasn't got position. Well, shots like the green under pressure shouldn't be allowed, Ted.
Amazing putt, wasn't it? And now just the pink to come for victory at 13 frames to 7. Stephen Hendry defeats Tony Meo and puts himself into the quarterfinals.
Stephen, what did you feel about that match?
I felt I played very well. I was very happy with the way I played, especially this morning. I felt when I was round about the black, I scored very heavily, and I never got out of position. My position was very good, which means I wasn't in any trouble while I was on a break.
You didn't have a great start to this morning's session. I don't think you potted a ball, did you?
I know, 99-0 the first frame. So I was glad when I made a century the next frame, because it meant I was... It warmed me up because I didn't want to be cold for, say, two or three frames.
Some people have been saying that you have been missing a few balls that you would normally pot in your matches here so far this year. What do you feel? There's a couple that you've actually looked disgusted at yourself a couple of times.
Well, there's a bit of pressure out there.
Yeah.
I've missed a few, but I mean, everyone misses shots now and then. I'm still in the quarterfinal, so I'm delighted.
You're happy with the play?
Delighted.
What about the pressure? Because, I mean, you've faced pressure before. Every time you play, there's pressure. But there's even more this time because people are quoting you as saying, I'm going to win, I'm going to take Davis off the number one. Do you actually say all these things?
Never. Ian says it sometimes.
Ian Doyle, your manager.
I don't quote to say something, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. I'm always confident, of course, but I never actually say what I'm going to do.
What are you going to do against Darren Morgan?
Hopefully beat him.
He's been saying some quite complimentary things about you. What about him as a player? I mean, he's done exceptionally well this
year. Yeah, tremendous. He's a great, great player. Since he's joined us about a couple of years ago or so, I've always known he's a great player. Hasn't done too well in the professional ranks. But I practiced with him 2 years ago when he first joined in New Zealand. I think we had five frames. He had three centuries and two 90s. And I thought, lovely, I'm getting a lot of practice here. So, I've always known he's a great player.
When you say joined us, I better explain that he's part of your camp with Ian Doyle and the same manager, of
course.
That's
right, yeah. I certainly don't think there'll be any shortage of big breaks in our match.
Pretty safe forecast, because if you look at the century break, Steve James still the best, but Hendry today, a 117. Turn over the page, we'll reveal a bit more. Because Hendry again, 106. Darren Morgan has got a 104. That was against Mike Hallin. And Hendry, another one at 103. They really have been pumping them in. And the Hendry-Morgan match starts tomorrow morning. I have another result for you. Jimmy White, as expected, really has got through against John Virgo. They were 4-4 at the end of their first session. Then Jimmy White had a tremendous second session. Won everything that was on the table there to go 12-4 and has got through 13-6. He will play Terry Griffiths. So we can now reveal for you the last eight in this year's Embassy World Championship. Steve Davis, the champion, of course, six times, plays Neil Folds, a former semi-finalist. Jimmy White plays Terry Griffiths, the 79 champion, and that match you can see in our late programme tonight. Stephen Hendry, the semi-finalist last year, plays the rookie Darren Morgan, the former world amateur champion. And Jimmy White, John Parrott, I should say, the runner-up last year, plays Cliff Thorburn, the champion of 1980. All that I look forward to, and as I say, Jimmy White to look forward to tonight, and that match with Darren Morgan. Now then, first chance to have a look at shot of the championship. As you know by now, two tickets can be won to all sessions of the final next Saturday and Sunday. We'll bring you here and look after you. This year, once again, we've selected nine shots. You have to try and work out which you think will be the best three. And this year, we've asked Stephen Hendry to go through them with me. He hasn't selected them. He's not one of the judges either. We'll tell you how to enter in a moment, but have a look at the shots. Try and pick out which you think will be the top three for this year at the Crucible in Sheffield. First of our nine shots is played by Cliff Wilson against Cliff Thorburn.
Down to the colours, Cliff requires two snookers to win the frame and gets the first by screwing back behind the blue. He plays it perfectly.
Shot one, Cliff Wilson. Shot two, Joe Johnson in his match against Darren Morgan.
Trailing by 7 points in this frame, this is the only red Joe can see. plays a tremendous long putt with a lot of power in bottom of the white ball. Comes back down and ends up with a perfect angle on any of the ball colours to come down for the last red and wins the frame.
Shot two, Joe Johnson. Shot three, one from Cliff Thorburn against Doug Mountjoy.
Cliff Thorburn, yet to score in this frame, has to plant the red onto the pink, onto the third red, which is a thin cut, into the corner pocket. After finishing perfect in the black, the frame is all his.
Shot three, Cliff Thorburn. Shot four, Steve James in the second round against the defending champion.
Flat ball finish. Steve Davis plays what he thinks is a good safety shot. Steve James plays one of his specials to trail by only one frame.
Shot four, Steve James. Shot five, one from Jimmy White and his match-winning break against Danny Fowler.
Brilliant positional shot by the wind here. A lot of right-hand side on the blue ball here to come round on three cushions to disturb the two reds by the black and finish perfect.
Shot five, Jimmy White. Shot six, one from Doug Mountjoy, fighting hard against Cliff Thorburn.
In the final frame, Doug Mountjoy, under a tremendous amount of pressure, plays a brilliant shot. Puts the white down the green, and the frame is alive again.
Shot six, Doug Mountjoy. Shot seven, Stephen Hendry, in his first round match.
This is my match against Elaine Robidoux, leading 9-7, playing the red above the pink. A lot of stun and check side to finish on the black for a match-winning break.
Shot seven, then, Stephen Hendry. Shot eight, Dean Reynolds against John Parrott, second round.
Tremendous knowledge of the angles here from Dean Reynolds. Comes off five cushions before hitting the red. And finishes off by leaving it safe. Tremendous shot.
Shot eight, Dean Reynolds. Shot nine, Steve Davis, first round against Eddie Charlton.
Leading by 8 points here, Steve plays the snooker behind the black with perfect pace. Very hard to judge. And Eddie fails to escape it.
Shot nine, the defending champion, Steve Davis. So, just to remind you, shot one was Cliff Wilson's snooker behind the blue. Shot two, Joe Johnson's frame-winning red pot and position. And shot three, Cliff Thorburn's three-ball plant. Shot four, Steve James's frame-winning black rocket shot. Shot five, Jimmy White potting the blue and releasing the reds by the black. And shot six, Doug Mountjoy's snooker in the final frame. Shot seven, Stephen Hendry's pot and position on the black. Shot eight, Dean Reynolds's five cushion escape. And finally, shot nine, Steve Davis's snooker behind the black. 3 out of 9. And this year, you can vote by telephone. What you do is ring that number, 0898 99 11 31. 0898 99 11 31. It's open 24 hours a day. There are 120 lines taking your calls. You'll be told what to do, but basically, you just say your choice of the three shots in order. You then give your name, your county, no need to give the full address, just the county and the postcode, and a daytime telephone number for you. We will contact you. It'll cost you 25p a minute cheap rate, 38p a minute normal rate. If you haven't got a phone or you live outside the British Isles, you can still use the postal system, the old cards, and I'm sure you know all about this. You put your selection on the left, first choice, second choice, third choice, and on the other side, your name, your address, and a daytime telephone number. And this is the address for the postcards. Shot of the Championship, BBC Television, The Crucible Theatre, 55 Norfolk Street, Sheffield, S147UP. Shot of the Championship, BBC Television, Crucible Theatre, 55 Norfolk Street, Sheffield, S147UP. And only postcards, please, for Shot of the Championship. And they must arrive by first post Thursday, the 26th of April. As for the telephone line, well, that line will be open until midday, Thursday, again, the 26th of April. There it is, the big prize on the Big Sports Show. That's it for now, but don't forget we have a late night program here. For that, with the news all up to date, we'll